So I work on a lot of little electronics projects like this and this, stuff like this, sometimes like this, and usually I will use things like this or this or this. And lately I've been wanting a power supply, a bench power supply with more range. I can pick any voltage I want within reason and not have to deal with the wall warts and all of that. And so I decided to build one. I decided that a simple linear power supply would be easy to make, would definitely suit my purposes. So I settled on a simple power supply based on the LM317 voltage regulator. And after looking at the data sheet, getting an idea of what I wanted to do, got a schematic together. I opened up Eagle and got to designing a circuit board for it. And once I got the circuit board done, I sent it off to OSH Park and had them made. They come back nice little purple boards. They've got the silk screen, purple solder mask, the whole nine yards, and they really come back looking good. This time I got the 2-ounce copper upgrade, so they're cheap and they really work good. Power supply is all done and buttoned up. Got some ventilation holes here to go with the fan in the back. I figure we give her a test now. I thought a cool way to do that would be to plug something into her. So we'll stick in some banana plugs. And then what we'll test her with is your ordinary garden variety dual triode preamp tube. I've got a nice little, I think it's a 12AU7. So looking at the bottom of the tube, we know pins 4 and 5 are where the juice goes, the heaters. 9's the center tap if you want to use 6.3 volts, but I never do. So we use 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll put the positive on 5. Doesn't matter which way you go, either or. Anyway, got her there. Pop off the light. Less light there. Less light there. It's on. Actually, I'll put the light on here so you can see what we're doing. We're going to move that up to just about 12.6 or close as I can get. 12.5. Yeah, 12.5 volts. There we go. Check it out. That's the heater filaments going. So I think we got our 12.6 volts. It doesn't have to be exact, you know, you're just heating up the cathode here, letting some electrons fly, and they're doing nothing because nothing else is hooked up, but check that out. And then pop it off, and there they go, right back out. Anyway, I think it was a success. It's going to be a handy little power supply, and no more wall warts.